Giridhar Jain, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchin Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now today I am going to deliver a lecture on autopolarity detector and indicator and attenuator circuit for DVM. Now learning outcomes of this session are: at the end of the session, students will be able to draw and design autopolarity detector and indicator and attenuator circuit for digital voltmeter. Now, contents are autopolarity detector and indicator circuit, attenuator circuit, and design considerations of the circuits. Now, this figure 1 shows the circuit for autopolarity detector and indicator. Now this circuit consists of the comparator A1 and A2 using op-amp, and op-amp A3 is connected as an inverting amplifier. Okay. Now output of comparator A1 is given to a Zener diode, so 180 ohm and Zener diode are connected as shown in figure. So output of comparator, because this operational amplifier is driven with plus 12 volt and minus 12 volt, therefore when output of comparator is high, so it will be plus 12 volt, and to clamp it to logic 1, the 4.7 volt Zener diode is used, and 180 ohm resistance will limit the current through Zener diode. Now similar circuit is used at the output of comparator A2, and op-amp A3 is connected as an inverting amplifier. So for the inverting amplifier, the gain is minus RF by R1. So R1 and RF are 1K, therefore gain of this inverting amplifier is minus 1. Then at the output of comparator A, output is connected to control switch SX, output of comparator formed by A2, so point B is connected to control switch SY. Now let us understand how this circuit operates. So this circuit will detect the polarity of input, and it will indicate if the input is negative by displaying this LED, okay, by glowing this LED. Now let input is positive Vin. Let input is positive. If input is positive, then output of comparator A1 is high and output of comparator A2 is low. Therefore, LED will be off. And as output of upper comparator A1 is high, right? So point A, it is connected to control switch SX, and therefore switch SX is closed. Now here, switch SX and SY are the solid state switches which are controlled electronically. Means when the output A is high, so it will close the solid state switch SX. Now when input is positive, output of comparator A1 is high, switch SX is closed, output of comparator A2 is low, switch SY is open. And therefore the input phi in, right, therefore input phi in through switch SX, it comes at the output and it is connected to input of a integrator input. Okay, so this autopolarity detector and indicator circuit is used at the input side. So input is applied to this circuit and output of this circuit is given to a integrator input for the DVM, which we have seen in the earlier lecture. Means when input is positive, it is transferred to input of integrator as it is. Now let us understand if input is negative, what will happen. When input is negative, output of comparator A1 is low and output of comparator A2 is high. Therefore, the LED is glowing, right? 180 ohm resistance will limit the current through LED, and that is the intensity of LED. So LED is glowing, which indicates that input is negative. When LED is not glowing, LED is off, input is positive, and when LED is on, input is negative. Okay. Now, when output of comparator A2 is high, which is point B, and it will close the switch SY. And output of comparator A1 is low, means switch SX is open. Now, when SX is open and SY is closed, now negative input is passed through the inverting amplifier, which is having a gain of minus 1, and therefore output of this inverting amplifier is a positive voltage. For example, if input is minus 2 volt and gain of this inverting amplifier is minus 1, means output of inverting amplifier is plus 2 volt. And as the SY is closed, so output of the inverting amplifier, so it is connected to input of integrator. So in this way, this circuit will pass the input as it is by closing switch SX, and it will invert the input by closing switch SY and passing the input through a inverting amplifier. Okay, so this circuit will detect the polarity of input by glowing the LED, right? If input is negative, LED is on. Now pause this video and think on the following question. So shall we measure the 2000 volt DC using DVM? Yes, 2000 volt DC can be measured, but that 2000 volt DC cannot be connected directly to the integrator input, because the op-amp can accept the input voltage up to the rated input, right? It cannot accept the 2000 volt, and therefore if you want to measure up to 2000 volt, say 0 to 2000 volt, then that voltage is to be attenuated by using a attenuator circuit. Now this figure shows the attenuator circuit for DVM, and this attenuator circuit is also we call as a range selector circuit, means we select the range of input voltage by operating these switches. Now this attenuator circuit consists of the 9 meg, 900K, 90K, 9K and 1K connected in series. Then switches SA, SB, SC, SD and SE as shown. And then 100K, then two Zener diodes connected in anti-parallel. Okay. And there is a buffer, voltage follower. Now input resistance of this buffer is high, which will avoid the loading effect, and the output of voltage follower, which is 0 to 0.2 volt, which is connected to the input of integrator. Now you can see, depending on the magnitude of input volt or the range of input voltage, a appropriate switch is to be selected, and this is given in the table 1 range selection. Now if input voltage is in between 0 to 0.2 volt, switch SA is closed and remaining switches are open, means input is passed as it is, and through buffer, voltage gain of the buffer is unity, so output is 0 to 0.2 volt. Similarly, if input is 0 to 2 volt, then switch SB is closed with other switches kept open. So in this case, what will happen if switch SB is closed? So 9 mega ohm upper resistance, and from that point to the ground, the sum of 900K, 90K, 9K and 1K. Okay. So if we proceed further for the equivalent circuit, now if switch SB is closed, so close the switch S2, and here let input is say 2 volt. So this is 9 meg and the low resistance. Now make sum of the low resistances, so it will come as 1 meg, and the simplified equivalent circuit becomes 2 volt, 9 mega ohm in series with 1 meg, and voltage across 1 meg is the output VO dash. Now if we apply a potential divider, VO dash is 1 meg upon 1 meg plus 9 meg, means 1 upon 10 into 2, so it is 0.2 volt, means 2 volt is converted to 0.2 volt by this circuit. Now similarly, for the range of 20 volt operate switch, SC, you can draw the similar equivalent circuit and verify yourself. And for the 200 volt, the switch SD is to be used, and for 2000 volt switch SE is to be used. Now this kind of circuit is used where there is a manual range selector switch provided for a multimeter. Means by observing the input voltage, you have to select the appropriate switch manually, right? Now design consideration. Now in this circuit, the comparators which are used in the circuit, so use high sensitivity comparator such as mu A710 or LM324, and for the operational amplifier which is used as an inverting amplifier, you can use LM324 or LM741. Okay, so these are references. Thank you for attending the lecture.